The Unwritten Constitution. The unwritten Constitution, as well as the Constitution's elasticity, adds to its viability. Political parties, the President's cabinet, political action committees, and the federal bureaucracy are important examples of traditions, precedent, and practice incorporated into our form of government. The elastic clause and direction given to the Congress in the Constitution is perhaps the greatest instrument of change that Congress has at its disposal. From the passage of the Judiciary Act of 1789 to the creation of the many executive branch departments, Congress has used its power to expand the size of government. Congress has used the elastic clause to pass civil rights legislation. It has broadly interpreted the meaning of interstate commerce and has passed a War Powers Act under its power to declare war. The President has interpreted the Constitution to allow for executive privilege, the ability of the President to protect personal material. Because the definition of executive privilege is not written, President Nixon, in trying to apply this to his Watergate tapes, did not succeed in protecting the tapes from a congressional committee investigating potential obstruction of justice charges. The President also has turned into the person responsible for proposing a legislative agenda. It was Bill Clinton who made eliminating the nation's budget deficit a priority in 1992. Neither the Constitution nor any law provides for the establishment of political parties, nominating conventions, primaries, and most of the political system we are used to. Even though the Federalist Papers warned of the danger of political factions, and George Washington echoed that point of view, the influence of political parties has become a dominant feature of government. When the Republican Party can unite and not provide a single vote for the President's budget proposal, one can see the importance of party politics. When a party decides to start a filibuster or continuous debate in the Senate to block the passage of legislation, this becomes an additional check. The Supreme Court has also gone beyond the constitutional parameters in establishing precedent. From the Marbury v. Madison decision establishing judicial review to Roe v. Wade, which found a way constitutionally to protect the right of a woman to have an abortion, the Court forges new ground based on its interpretation of the Constitution. Custom and tradition are an integral part of our government. After executive departments were established by Congress, Washington announced the formation of cabinet positions. Congress then codified this concept as they approved additional cabinet positions. A two-term president was the accepted tradition until Franklin Roosevelt broke it. After he died, an amendment limiting presidential term was passed, making the tradition a written component of the Constitution. After John Kennedy was assassinated, the Presidential Succession Amendment was ratified. Little did the country realize that it would be used not as a result of an assassination, but rather because the country's Vice President, Spiro Agnew, and, not much later, the President, Richard Nixon, would resign. This lesson focused on the document that sets the course for American government and politics. An understanding of the Constitution makes your job easier as you look more closely at the specific workings of our government and political system.